My God, dude, these mosquitoes. Unbelievable, these little bastards, man. I'm up to 14, man. 14's my kill count. I'll keep going, motherfucker. Come on, get out of here, man.
Yo, what is going on, ladies and gentlemen? Jeff back here. We are moving on with Project Xylus. We are now going to be getting to doing the front splitter. We're going to be putting under the front bumper. It's going to be legit. It's going to look awesome. As I had mentioned previously, I had some splitter rods coming in the mail. Happy to say they have finally arrived and they are meeting all of my expectations. They are beefy as hell, looking hella sick. They're going to look great on this splitter, great on the bumper. I cannot wait. I didn't spare any expense. I didn't want some cheapy things that were just going to break after a couple of drives, so I went ahead and splurged a little bit, spent a little bit extra on some high quality ones, some actual racing hardware, and I'm really glad I did. When I got these things in the mail, I was very happy with them. I'll show you those in just a second. But before we get into the splitter business, I'm going to show you guys what I've been doing. I've been having a little bit of trouble with this camera here, so I haven't been able to do any recording for the last couple of days. And on that note, I actually ordered a new camera, so I'm going to be replacing this camera very soon, within the next week or two, whenever it arrives. Video quality should be a whole lot better. Look forward to that. It's going to be cool. But for now, you know, using what I got, so it's going to have to be good enough for the moment. But while I haven't been able to record, I've still been wanting to keep busy, so what I did is I started my prep work for my flares, and I haven't actually gotten started on doing any of the sculpting or anything like that yet, or any of the real serious stuff yet, because I wanted to save that and record all of it so I could show you guys. I didn't want you to miss any of it, so I didn't record anything, or I couldn't record anything, and I didn't get in too deep. But what I did do is I started the masking process to mask off the paint that I do not want to damage on the Z. And I'm going to show you that, what that looks like. I'm also going to show you the materials that it takes to do a project like this. I'm not going to go into detail on each of the things that you need in this video, but when we actually get into doing the flares, I'll go step by step and show you each one of the things that I'm going to be using. But I'm going to give you a brief look at the materials that I'm going to be using to do the flare project. And you'll see, it's quite a bit. If you're going to do something as extensive as this, you need a little bit. So this is just a quick look at the materials I'm going to be using. Again, I'm not going to go over in detail. I will be doing that in the actual flare building video series. It's basically just resin, you got body filler, you got gel coat, fiberglass. We'll get into all that later, but check this out. So here is the Z right now in its current state. You can see that this is all masked off really, really well. And this is where we're obviously going to be building the new flares for the back, for the rear quarter panels. And it's all aluminum foil, double layered aluminum foil over the paint and everything. And it's double sided taped down. Again, I'm going to be going over all this stuff in the actual flare series. Just a brief look at what I've been doing in the meantime while I haven't been able to record. So it's all protected. Resin is really nasty. It tends to get right through anything that's paper. Like if I were to just mask this off with regular masking tape, it would go right through that and right into my paint. That's why you need something like aluminum foil, something that is not going to be penetrated by the resin. So that's why it's all very, very well protected. And it's double and in some areas triple layered. So just to be safe, I did not want to spare any expense to really make sure that this was completely covered. But you'll notice that black line right there. That is where the flare is going to be shaped. I also have the polyurethane flare base already mounted on there, and it is solid. It's in the exact position that I'm going to be using as my base. And then I'm going to just be laying up clay right over the top of it and sculpting my flare. And then once the flare is sculpted, I'm going to make symmetry ribs, and we're going to copy that exactly on the other side with those ribs. I will show you all that when we get into that series. But this is what the rear quarter panels are looking like right here. In case some of you guys weren't sure if I was really serious or not, there's your answer. I'm dead serious. So anyway, let's get into talking about the splitter. All right, out here in front of the car now, Xylus looking hella clean, as always. So I've got laid out here a nice big old piece of cardboard. Now this cardboard, if any of you guys are wondering where I might have gotten a big piece of cardboard like this, when I ordered my Siegestyle louvers, they came packaged in this box right here. So props to the guys over there at Siegestyle
for the big old box that I'm now going to be using to make my splitter. And I have my big piece of ABS plastic, my 3/8 ABS plastic that I showed you guys previously. It's just kind of laid out just to measure. It's cut exactly to the length of my bumper, so it gives me a really good idea of how much of this cardboard I'm going to need, how much real estate I'm going to be using. So obviously I'm not going to need this portion right here, although I may use this extra piece right here to do some templates for canards or whatever. But anyways, we need about that much cardboard. What I'm going to need to do is go ahead and remove the rear bumper, and we're going to move the ABS plastic off the cardboard. We're going to set the bumper directly on top of the cardboard, and then I'm going to tape it down a little bit so that I'm sure that it doesn't move. It's going to become essentially one piece with the cardboard. And then I'm going to just take a pencil, something with a line that I can erase with an eraser, and I'm just going to go ahead and trace a line around the bumper until I have a shape that I'm happy with, and that's going to end up being the final shape for our splitter on the outside. And so once we have the template or a shape that we like, we can remove the bumper off the cardboard, and then we can cut that out of the cardboard, and then we can transfer that shape perfectly onto the ABS plastic. We'll just lay the cardboard directly on top of the ABS plastic, and we'll be good to go. We'll just perfectly mimic the shape on the ABS plastic, and then we can cut the splitter out of the plastic, and we'll be good. Now, one thing to note is that you want to make sure that you have perfect symmetry. I'm a fairly decent artist, but I mean, I'm not perfect by any means, and there's no way in hell that I could perfectly get an absolutely perfectly symmetrical curve, no matter how hard I tried, you know, just trying to draw a line all the way across. So the idea is, what you want to do is you want to find the center point. Once you lay the bumper on the cardboard, probably not the most ideal time to be doing this because of the sun right now, but anyways, you want to find the center point of your bumper when it's on the cardboard, and you want to mark that line, okay? And you want it to stay right there. You do not want it to move. And then you just want to draw one side up to that line. Just draw the curve to one side. And then once you have that line, what you can do is you can actually fold, you cut that out, and then you can actually fold it over along that line, and then you can just trace the folded cardboard so that it's perfectly mimicking on the other side. You know what I'm saying? So that way you get both lines on both sides perfectly symmetrical. So that's how I'm going to end up doing my splitter template. Then we'll put that on top of the ABS, and then we'll mark that out. That way I know I'll be 100% accurate on both sides. Easy breezy, no problem. I'm going to show you the splitter rods that I got. We got a big ass truck coming. Remember what I told you? Every time I start trying this, like a big ass truck or something starts coming. That's exactly what I'm talking about. Yeah, man, exactly what I was talking about. And before that, before I even started this video, just as I was about to hit record for the first time, homeboy two houses down starts weed eating his lawn. Just classic, classic's what I was talking about. But anyway, check these splitter rods out. These things are legit. So as I stated, I went ahead and splurged a little bit on these. Now there's so many different splitter rods that you can get online. You can get anything from like cheapy, like $5-$10, little cheapy splitter rods, or you can spend a little bit more, $60 to $100. You know, and get something that's a little higher quality. And that's exactly what I did. I figured, hey, I love my car, and you know, I don't want to just put a bunch of cheap parts on it. I want it to be a high quality build and all that. So what I went ahead and did is I went ahead and ordered these, and these are by Fully Torqued Racing. And these are super heavy duty, nice construction. These are actual racing hardware. Like, these are not cheapy little aluminum jobs. These are really, really well made. You can see just by looking at them, there's nothing cheap about them. They're nice and solid and not too cheap feeling at all. But these are what I'm going to be running for my splitter. These are the, I believe, the 9.5 to 11.5 sizing, and that's going to be just perfect. I measured it out before I even ordered these. I measured it out to see exactly how much length I would need for this particular splitter and this bumper setup. So the 9.5 to 11.5 measured perfectly. That's exactly what I needed, and thankfully that's exactly what they offered. They also have longer ones that extend out longer. They have shorter ones if you're running a shorter setup, but this 9.5 to 11.5 was perfect for me. So again, these are by Fully Torqued Racing. You can get these on Amazon. I paid $65 for these. Hella good investment. They look sick. Can't wait to get those installed. It's gonna look really good. Now, I have not decided just yet how I want to mount them. I'm not sure if I want to mount them straight coming down like that or at an angle like that. We'll have to see. We're gonna experiment a little bit with it and see what I like, but regardless, however I choose to mount them, it's gonna be fantastic. And I can be happy that I got some quality splitter rods on there, not some garbage that's just gonna break off in the first day. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and get started on removing the bumper at this point. Obviously, you can't do this with the bumper on the car, so I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of that. It's just gonna be a matter of 3 10-millimeter bolts on each side, and then, of course, the clips that are under the hood there. Alright, so now that we have the bumper off the car, you'll notice that I dropped it right down onto the cardboard. I just pushed the cardboard right under where the bumper was going to fall, and then I just dropped the bumper right down on top of the cardboard, because that makes it easy for us to just go ahead and pull the whole thing out. Slide the whole thing out so we got plenty of room to work with. I'm doing this in my driveway here. Running out of light pretty soon here, but trying to get as much done as I possibly can. So now we're going to go ahead and reposition the bumper into the area that we want. I think I'm just going to position it right in the middle. Push it back, because that way these creases right here are not going to interfere at all with the actual folding of the cardboard. All right, so what I'm gonna actually use to get the center point in the bumper at this point is I actually have a laser level. So I'm gonna get my laser level out, and I'm gonna put it right in the center of the bumper. And I'm gonna have to eyeball it because I don't have an actual measurement for it, but I'm gonna look at that red line, make sure it's looking straight up and down on the bumper as close as possible, at least with the human eye. So I'm gonna get out my laser level. All right, so I got my laser level going. And you can see, hopefully the camera picks this up, stuck right between here. So you can see this line right here that's coming from the laser level, and it's lining up perfectly right up the middle. You can actually see it on the car too, maybe. Anyways, I can see the line lined up right through the middle of the car. So I actually lined the bumper up perfectly, and I got, god dang man, these mosquitoes are just unbelievable. I'm getting eaten alive here. Anyways, I got my ruler out, and I just went ahead and measured from one end of the line right there to that little edge. So I set my ruler right there, and from the edge I got about 5.5, and then on the other side, right from the edge, just about 5.5. It's just like a little bit, it doesn't have to be 100% perfect, but it's like really close. It's within about 1/8 of an inch, so that's going to be good enough. I just barely pushed that. There we go. So that's going to be perfectly. So I know for a fact that that's going to be absolutely right down the center. And like I said, it doesn't have to be absolutely perfect. It can be a little off, and you're still going to be fine, because when you actually get to the point of cutting it and everything, there's always going to be a little bit of adjustment anyway. So just get it as close as you can. You really don't have to have a laser level or anything like that. I just happen to have one, so why the hell not use it, you know? So anyways, what I'm gonna do at this point is I'm gonna go ahead and follow this line straight down, and I'm gonna actually draw it onto the cardboard with a pencil. Okay, so I've gone ahead and taken my pencil and perfectly measured out that line right there. I just took my ruler and I set it right up against the line, and then just perfectly measured that, so you can see, or marked that, I should say. You can see how that line comes right down and matches that pencil mark right there. So we're gonna leave the bumper right there. I'm actually gonna go get a couple of pieces of tape, and I'm gonna tape down the back portion. Just a couple of pieces in the front too. Just tape down the back flaps right there if you got a bumper like this one, just so it won't move. You don't want it to move at all at this point. It's right in the center. You know, I actually should have put the tape on before I did the laser level and all that, but I'll just be really careful and put the tape on right now so that we can plant the bumper down onto the cardboard. Then we're gonna go ahead and start on this side over here, and we're gonna start marking our shape with our pencil. All right guys, so I've gone ahead and done the line that I'm happy with. Had to go over a couple of times. and do just a couple of different tests for different shapes and stuff that I was testing out, but this is what I finally decided on. It's simple, but it's definitely going to look absolutely dope. I mean, you can see where it's just going to extend just a tiny little bit out right here, and that's so that if I want to, I can actually add a winglet to the side. So I wanted a little bit extra on the outsides. That's why I just, when I bought my plastic, I accounted for that and ordered just a little bit longer than the edges of the bumper. I didn't just get exactly how long the bumper was. I got just about 3/4 of an inch extra on the sides so that I can add winglets to this little area right here, if I want to. If not, then I can either shave that off or just keep it like that and just kind of round out the corners or whatever. I'll figure it out. But this is the shape that I decided on. It's going to look perfect. Now do keep in mind that this center area right here is going to be raised up. So you can see on the Nismo V3 bumper, it has that raised diffuser in the center. Now the splitter is actually going to go ahead and follow that same thing where it's going to come up and raise up like that. And then the rods are going to be attached there and possibly diagonal or maybe straight up. I'm not sure. Like I said, I haven't decided how I'm going to mount those yet, but the splitter is going to follow that same shape. Here's a look at it from the side. It's going to follow that and just curl up right there in the front. It's going to look sick. So this is the shape that I'm going to be going with. Now what I ended up doing is I ended up measuring out a box. I placed the ABS plastic sheet just behind the bumper, perfectly squared from edge to edge. And then I actually drew a line and perfectly created how much plastic I actually have, a template. So with that, I was able to actually measure how far forward I'm going to be able to come with it. If I would have just, you know, just done it by eye and come way out here or something, well then I would have found out that I don't have enough plastic for that. So I had to actually measure out the exact amount of plastic that I have and then actually draw my line to that. So we should be perfect with this. So what I'm going to do at this point is I'm going to go ahead and remove the bumper from the cardboard, and then I'm going to cut this out, and then I'm going to fold it over the cutout side over onto the other side of the cardboard, and then I'm going to go ahead and trace that exact curve right there on this side. So you can see I've got it all cut out at this point. So here was the center line right there. It's actually right there to be specific. I got it cut out with my X-Acto knife to the exact shape. Everything was cut real nice and smooth, as close as I could. You know, it's kind of impossible to get absolutely perfect, but that's okay. Don't worry about this line right here because, you know, get it as close as you can, but there's always going to be a little refinement. You're going to be sanding that anyways, so you'll be able to correct any little mistakes in the line right there if they translate through to the plastic. So don't worry about that too much. But what you do want to worry about is this center line right here. Now this center line, I was very, very careful to cut that exactly down the center where that line was, where we lined it up. What I did is I took my big ass aluminum ruler, this long boy, and I laid it right up against the line. Then I took my blade right up against the ruler and I just cut it straight down. So you want that super straight, because when you now go to pick this up, like so, what we're gonna end up doing is flipping this around to the other side. Now you can see, hopefully you can see, this line right here and that line. This is where the plastic lays in its full intact state. So we can lay this and line this up exactly with this line right here on the reverse side. So you got the front side of the plastic right here. So what we're going to end up doing now is we're just going to end up tracing this and going that way with it. All right. And then once that's traced out, we're going to end up taping these two pieces back together. I'm just going to take a piece of masking tape. I'm going to sandwich the two pieces back together perfectly and then take a piece of thick masking tape and just run it down the center so that it's all one piece again. Now, the reason I decided to do it this way as opposed to just folding it over is because I felt like if I folded it, due to the nature of the cardboard, there was going to be just a little bit of cardboard that was going to be lost. And so I decided that it would be a better move to actually cut it. That way you get an absolutely perfect match, and then just go ahead and tape it back again. So what you're gonna do is after both sides are done, you're just gonna push this back together. The line should line up absolutely perfectly because you cut it carefully. And then we're just gonna run a piece of packing tape and just seal it back down together. Then you've got your perfect template, okay? Then we're gonna take that, cut this side out, lay that on top of the plastic, copy that design onto the plastic, then cut it out in the plastic. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and emulate this shape onto the other side and get it cut out. All right, guys, and there you have the exact shape of our splitter. This is what it's going to be when it's cut out in the plastic or thereabouts. May not be 100% perfect, but it's gonna be about 95% perfect, accurate on both sides. Just due to the cutting nature of it and everything, it's kind of impossible to get cardboard exactly 100% perfect, but this is gonna be definitely good enough for when you translate that back onto the plastic and then go back in and do your finishing and your sanding and all that. You can really fine tune that line perfectly. So this is going to be our cardboard template. So the next step is to go ahead and imprint this template onto the plastic, and we'll go ahead and use like a colored pencil or something like that, something that's going to show up on that black ABS. You can't just use like a regular pencil or a Sharpie or something because you're never going to see your line. So you got to use something that shows a little bit of a line, and then we'll just go ahead and cut it out of the plastic, and then we can start the process of test fitting it, seeing where we need to create our mounting holes, both on the bottom of the bumper and on the bottom of the undercarriage of the car, where we're gonna try and mount at least the front two bolts where the factory under tray used to be. I'm gonna try and mount at least the back portion of it up under there with a couple of bolts just to get it nice and secured. What I may choose to do is cut out as much of this as I don't need, because that 3/8 inch ABS is really heavy. And so I want to make sure I'm cutting out as much of it as I don't absolutely need. So what realistically it may look like is you'll get the outer edge, obviously, but this portion right here in kind of these recesses in the sides may be cut out, and then the center portion will be full to mount to the underneath of the car. And so you'll have kind of this kind of M type of shape going on. But that's just to save weight. I could just run the entire plate underneath, but it's definitely gonna be pretty heavy. I'm gonna wanna save as much weight as I possibly can. So let's go ahead and put this on the ABS plastic. We'll get it traced out, and then we'll go ahead and start cutting it out. All right, so I've gone ahead and laid the cardboard template over the ABS plastic. I then took a white colored pencil, something like this, and I just carefully traced along the template so that I get that exact line on both sides. Now you might notice there's a little bit of a difference on the edges there than what you previously saw in the template, and that's because I did go ahead and make a slight modification to my line. As you can see here, instead of going ahead and making a brand new template, what I went ahead and did is just added a couple of extra pieces of cardboard and then taped them down really good, and then just redrew the new line that I wanted. Basically, I just added a little bit of an extra edge to the corners there just to line up more with the shape of the actual diffuser on the bumper. Because when I looked at it back in my video footage, I decided that I wanted to add a little bit more space right here so that when I add a side winglet, if I decide to do that, I'm gonna have a perfect amount of space right here, and it's gonna be all symmetrical instead of adding that curve in right here how it was previously. I wanted to add a little bit more so that I could get a nice straight edge for my side winglet to mount to. So that's kind of why I just added a little bit extra. And it was real easy. I just put, like I said, put a couple of extra pieces of cardboard right there and then just taped them down and just redrew the line, folded it back over again, and then just did the same thing on the opposite side. Then I laid it back down and traced it. Okay, so now what we have to do is cut this out. I mean, you can use like a skill saw or something like that. This is the 3/8 inch ABS plastic, so it's pretty thick. You're definitely not going to get like a razor through that or anything like that, so you are going to need to cut this with a blade. I do have here a little multi-tool. It's a little oscillating blade. Now I could use this. I actually did a little test there in the corner, if you can see, and it does get through it, but I think what I want to use is a actual skill saw to get through this, and I don't have one on me, so I'm going to go to my friend's house real quick and pick one up so I can get through this. And this does work, but I just want that really nice straight line. With this, you get a little bit of a curve to it or whatever, and you might mess up your angle, so I didn't want to take that chance. So I'm just gonna go run to my friend's house real quick, grab a skill saw, and then get a nice straight cut on this thing, and we'll be ready to move on to the next step. All right, I went to my homeboy's place, He let me use his skill saw, so we're gonna be able to get right through this no problem. Now what I did is I went ahead and put the plastic right on a solid little table there, something that's not gonna move, and then I went ahead and C-clamped it so that it's nice and solid right down on the top there. So we're just essentially gonna be taking the saw and cutting right along this line as closely as possible. You know, again, perfection is what you're going for, but it's more than likely not what you're gonna get. Just get as close as you absolutely can, and then you'll be able to refine that line a little bit more in your sanding process. All right, so let's get started, start cutting this bad boy out. I'm super excited to finally get this thing cut out to its actual shape, and then we're gonna end up doing a little bit of heat right here and bending this front lip upward. So we got it all cut out now. Not gonna lie, this was a bit of a bitch, and I actually had to switch between both tools, both my cutting blade and my buddy's, because this one definitely, the skill saw definitely cut quicker and faster, but the problem is this plastic is so thick and that blade gets so hot that the plastic just keeps on re-welding to itself, because it actually melts along the seam and re-welds. So I had to actually go back in with the thinner blade, this one right here, with the wider blade on it, so that the plastic was kept away from the other side so it wouldn't re-weld. So I actually had to use a little bit of both, but it worked fine. So what we're left with is a fairly clean cut all the way around, but you're going to get all this stuff, all this flashing and stuff on the end, and this is obviously that melted plastic that just rises up on the end. This will definitely need to be taken off or sanded off or whatever you want to do. But like I said, this is where we're now going to go in and do all of our refinement, where we actually go in and we sand all this down and sand this line to get it nice and perfect on both sides. It's looking really good. The cut was definitely good enough, so I'm now going to be able to go ahead and get rid of all this stuff and start the sanding process. So I got all the flashing right off the top there. So the top is still looking real nice and clean. I'm now gonna go ahead and go in with my orbital just around the edge, trying to keep it as upright as I can. Just get a nice, super clean edge all the way around just to get off all that little furry stuff and to close up any little lines. Like you can see right here, there's a little gap between, there's my white line right there. Little gap right there. I'm just gonna close that up with my sander. And so this is your refinement stage, really. When you go in with your sander, this is where you can really start to tighten up the line a little bit. Hopefully you didn't get in too deep anywhere with your saw. If you did, you can go in with a little bit of body filler if you need to at this point, but hopefully you didn't. And if anything, you want to make sure you're cutting outside that line so you can just sand it back down into your line. Thankfully, I got a pretty good cut here. I got in a little bit too deep, like right there, and that's like the only little spot, but I'm not even going to do body filler. I'm just going to actually close that line in a little bit so it completely blends that, and that will be perfectly fine. So let's get to sanding. So here's a perfect example of what I mean by your refining stage. So this edge now is just about completely finished right here. You can see here's where I accidentally got in a little bit too deep right here. But now you cannot even see that. It's all perfectly sanded down. Everything's looking super clean. So all I did is I just took that edge just in a little bit and then sanded everything nice and flush. Rounded that corner out real nice, and that's looking super clean. Now we're just gonna go ahead and finish the rest of the way. Make all of it look just like that. Yeah, man, that is looking really nice. Nice and clean all the way around from one side to the other. That curve is coming out perfectly. Just made any little minor adjustments that I needed to make while I was sanding. Didn't really have to adjust very much, but you can see how nice that line is all the way across. And just to double check it, I put the cardboard template back on top and I checked the lines on the top and it looks really good from the top. And then I put the plastic on top of the cardboard to check that way as well. And the lines are very, very clean as well. Very, very close to the original template. You can just see those couple little minor adjustments that I made that are not gonna affect the overall shape at all. So I'm very happy with what we're looking like at this point. Looking good. What I am gonna end up doing is actually beveling this edge. I'm gonna round this edge out and then we're gonna go ahead and curve this front portion up. Now this plastic is super, super thick, so curving this front portion is not gonna be easy at all. I'm gonna have to use liberal amounts of heat as well as probably the C-clamp and probably a couple C-clamps, and somehow I'm gonna have to figure out a way to get this to be pulling up while I'm applying heat to this section right here so that this front lip can kind of bend upward. It's gonna take time for sure. It's not gonna happen real quick just because this is 3/8 inch ABS. It's super thick and it does not bend easily. You know, you can see even with this much length, it's barely bending, you know, even when I flex it from one end of it. So it's gonna take a lot of pressure for me to bend this up. So what I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to prop it, somehow clamp it, the top end, while I'm pressing down on the back end, and pull this section up while I have the heat going. And over time, it's gradually gonna bend up. So it'll take a while, but we'll get to it for sure. But this is what it's looking like so far, looking hella good. All right, I got my bevel set in. Oh, I just beveled the top portion. I left about a quarter of an inch of the straight edge on the bottom there because that is where the gold trim is gonna go. That's gonna follow from my side skirts. It's gonna follow in through the front splitter as well. So if I put the camera here, you can see how that edge has been beveled perfectly down to that quarter inch all the way across. So a nice little curve, little angle right over the top just to give it that extra little professional look so that it doesn't just come square out to the end and look kind of choppy or squared, you know, too squared. I don't like too much of the squared look. The beveled look just looks a lot more professional. So you can see I didn't bother to bevel the edges here because I'm going to be fixing winglets right there. So I need a nice flat surface to apply my however I choose to apply them, probably that double-sided tape or maybe some glue or something right there. So I need a nice full flat surface right there. So I didn't bevel through the sides, just along the curve there. It's looking hella sick. All right, so now I'm gonna go ahead and start trying to bend up this front portion. So I'm gonna rig up some kind of a stand or something where I can get this bottom piece solidly planted down on the ground and this front part lifted up. I might have to use some weights or something and then start applying some heat to just gradually get that front portion to start lifting up. Well, trying to bend this thing has been a total pain in the ass. This 3/8 inch plastic is just so sturdy, it just does not want to bend, especially when you only have 2 feet worth of leverage. I have tried multiple things to try and get this to bend. I propped it up upside down on a table and then actually C-clamped a weight to the front of it so that the front portion would actually bend down over the table, and then I hit it with 2 heat guns going at the same time for about an hour. I got a little bit of curve out of it, but I want to see a little more curve to it right now. It's only probably about a half inch to three inch curve lift in the front, which I mean is better than nothing. If I can't even get it to curve any more than that, then that's going to be okay. You know, it'll be better than if it was just flat, but I'm definitely looking to get a little bit more curve out of this. So I've now taken it outside and I've got this really kind of ghetto rigged up situation going on here where I've propped it up against the steps in my backyard, and I got some heavy stones, some blocks here weighing down on the center of it, and I've got some heat on it, maximum power heat that I actually previously had directly on top of it, but I've moved off to the side now for safety's sake. And I'm gonna leave this on here for, you know, a little while today while I go to work and just see if I can't get just the slightest amount of curve. If I can get even another quarter inch worth of curve out of it, that would really make me happy. But again, like I said, even if I can't, it's got at least a little bit of curve in it and it's gonna look really good. And the other thing is once I get my splitter rods in there, the splitter rods will also help to pull that up a little bit. So this is where we're at. This has been an absolute pain in the ass to get this to bend. And I knew it would be too. I knew with the 3/8 inch plastic, I was really gonna have a hell of a time, and sure enough, I was right. So anyways, we're moving along with this. This is taking a lot longer than I had anticipated, unfortunately. I'm working as quickly as I can to get this up, and then we'll get this thing on the car and move on to the flares. I definitely want to get on to the next project at this point. But it's looking good so far, just need to get a little more curve.
So I got the splitter out here on the driveway again. I got a good amount of bend in it. Still wasn't as much as I wanted, but it's a good amount and something that I'm happy with. Definitely looks better than it would if it was just flat. So I'm gonna show you guys what this is looking like. I got the bumper laying on top of it at this point, and I also mocked up my splitter rods. So you guys are gonna get a good look at what this is gonna look like in its final form once it's mounted on the car. Check this out, it's looking dope.
All right, so here's what we got so far. You can see that little amount of bend that I was able to achieve. It's probably about an inch, inch and a quarter, maybe even close to an inch and a half right there in the center that I was able to get that front end to bend up. And it's looking really good. A lot better than it would if it was just flat, like I said. So especially through the sides. Let me come over here.
And it's windy as hell right now, so I hope you guys can hear what I'm saying. New camera that I got coming shouldn't have this problem whatsoever. But you can see through the side there, just that slight little bend up on it, it really just looks great. It just flows right with the diffuser that's already on the bumper, as opposed to looking like it's a contrasting shape coming out just flat. Just that, even that slight amount of bend right there just goes a long, long way to really add, enhance the look of this splitter and bumper combo.
So dude, it is looking sick. You can see obviously where I've mounted my splitter rods. They're just mocked on there with some double side tape right now, but that is definitely where I'm gonna be fastening them. And I tried a bunch of different positions to see which ones that I like the best. Like I said, I tried it in the middle. I tried them a little closer in and all that, but this right here was just what stuck out so much to me. I loved it. I loved the look of it. It's just gonna be gently pulling up right there on those two sides just to create a little bit of lift and secure the splitter onto the bumper a little better. So that's what I'm going for. Hope you guys like that. It's looking sick to me. Coming back through the back now. I have not bolted the splitter to the bumper yet. I haven't even drilled my holes yet, but I'm gonna show you guys what I have in mind. So what I'm thinking is there's gonna be 12 bolts. There's gonna be six coming through this way to the center and six coming that way down through the center. And so I went to the hardware store and I bought my hardware. And because this plastic is so thick, I definitely needed some fairly extended hardware. So I went out and got these inch long bolts here, and these are gonna do just fine. I also got a bunch of washers, and that comes with all the nuts and everything for it as well. So I'm gonna do double washer, one on the bottom and one on the top when I fasten that together. And I'm gonna do one here, one here, one here, one here, and then one here, one here. It's going to be underneath, obviously. It's not going to come up through this, but it's actually going to be under here. And then there's going to be two there, and then four more there. And those are just going to be the bolts that are going to be fastening the front portion of the bumper to the splitter. But we are also going to be attaching, you can see these lines, one here, and there's one right there, perfectly measured out into the center. And those lines correspond to, going under the car here, correspond to these mount holes right here. So this, the side of this little bracket right here, two right here on the other side as well, the side here. Those lines are here and here on the splitter. So we're gonna be mounting right there and there under the radiator core support there as well. So that's where I'm gonna be mounting it to the car, and those bolts will be approximately right here and right here. We are almost done with this thing. I'm so excited. I'm also going to cut out all the unnecessary plastic back there. I showed you guys that briefly before. So I'm gonna end up cutting probably all this right here and all that inside there that I don't need. All that stuff that's just kind of sitting there unnecessarily. Of course, I'm gonna maintain all the plastic up and through the front and where I have my bolts. But all that extra stuff up to about this line right here on both sides is all getting cut out to save weight. It's gonna be just fine. It's not gonna compromise the piece at all. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna go ahead and start fastening these four bolts. I'm gonna go ahead and drill holes, like I said, four on each side. And I'm gonna drill my holes down through the top. For these ones that are under here, it's gonna be a little more difficult. I'm actually gonna need to go from underneath and drill up underneath. So I'll need to do four, just do careful measuring, and then flip the whole splitter upside down and then measure it out exactly, and then do four like that. And then that way I'll be able to just put the hardware up underneath and then screw the nut and the washer and everything on from the top side. Should work out just good, so I'm gonna go ahead and get started doing that.
All right, guys, so after 5 days of building this thing, I'm happy to say this is the final day. We are gonna be getting it completed today. I put in the rest of the work last night to get everything all bolted up, get everything taken care of underneath the car as well, and it's looking absolutely fantastic. Check this out, you guys. I think you'll agree this thing is looking absolutely dope and is a wonderful addition to this bumper and this car. Check it. So looking pretty wicked, man. I am loving the way that this thing is looking. It just extends the bottom of the bumper down just that extra 3/8 of an inch to really give it a little bit more of a lower, more aggressive stance, an aggressive look. I think it looks absolutely awesome. I hope you guys do too. Now I'm gonna actually go into the car and I'm gonna show you guys exactly how I did the bolts on this thing. I ended up doing 13 bolts to mount the front portion of the splitter to the bumper, and then I did the 2 bolts in the back portion of the splitter to mount the splitter to the car, the actual radiator core support. So it's really nice and secure. It's also, of course, got the splitter rods there, so that's also helping to support the front end of it and help to lift it up to prevent it, the air from pushing it down too much. So there should be no problems with this thing staying on the car at all. I'm gonna show you guys how I did all my bolt work. Now, it is fully mounted on the car, so I will need to go under the car. I don't want to take the whole thing off after I put it all on there already. So I'm going to go under the car and show you from the underneath. You will also see, as we're under there, the cutouts that I did on the inside. As I briefly explained previously, I was going to go ahead and cut out areas of the splitter that I didn't need just to save weight. You're going to see that under the car as I go under there. And I made sure to do a good job too. I didn't just hack it up, you know. I made sure to smooth it out, make it look as professional as possible, and I hope you guys will agree. This thing is definitely a nice high quality job. I did my best. It's not perfect. You know, there's some little few things here and there, but I'm definitely happy with it. For the price that I paid, you know, I paid about $130 for the plastic and $60 for the rods and, you know, other miscellaneous hardware and stuff that was like $5 to $10. Less than $200 to get this super heavy duty splitter, I'd say that's definitely worth it. So let me get under the car and show you guys all the bolt work in case you're making one of these for your own, so you can see just how much I went through to get this thing mounted to the car, nice and secure. All right, so coming underneath the car here, this is driver's side. Underneath here, you can see the bolting that I did. I did the one in the corner, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then I decided to put one in the center, that's 7. And then coming over to the other side, on this side, same exact thing, one in the corner, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then the one in the center again. So total, you have 13 bolts along the front portion of the splitter, bolting the front portion to the bumper itself, okay? And then in through the back, you can see there's my 2 radiator core support bolts. One here, double washer, extended. It's about a 2.5 inch bolt.
That's what I decided to do because the splitter actually comes down lower than the mounting hole. So I actually had to use a 2.5-inch bolt with a spacer. I actually cut a nylon spacer down to size. I'll get under there and show that to you right now. Hopefully you guys can see that. So here's one of my back bolts here going into the radiator core support. And you can see, hopefully, here's my spacer that I made, my nylon spacer right there. And it's a 2.5-inch bolt going from the bottom of the splitter into the spacer and then up into the mounting hole underneath the radiator core support. I got that going on both sides. The other one is over here. I'm not sure if you can see that. It's over there. So that's nice and secure. It is like really, really secure. Nice and tight up in there. Not gonna be falling down at all. I added the spacer. I cut it down exactly to size. I ended up measuring from the mounting hole down to where the splitter was straight, coming in straight. And then I just cut down the nylon spacer down to the exact size. And you can see under here, here's where I cut it out, right here. All this used to be, all the way from the back, it used to be straight across, plastic all the way across. But you can see where I cut this out. All of this has been cut out to the edge of the bumper on the inside, on both sides. I'm gonna crawl back out from under the car here and give you a view from the other side. Easier for you to see. So here, you can see where I cut that out. Right there. And like I said, I tried to do a really nice job too. I sanded down all the edges. I paid just as much attention to the edges on the inside as I did on the outside. You know, so it's nice and clean. There's not gonna be any sharp plastic edges or anything like that. If I ever need to take this off, I'm not gonna cut my hands on it or anything, but it's all really nicely cut on the inside just to save all that weight in there. So it's really, really secure and looking clean, even on the underneath. Everything is done right. I took my time with it, guys. If you're doing a project like this, if you're putting something on your car and you're gonna be driving around with it, take your time with it and do it right. You know, don't just do a quick hack job and, you know, just be satisfied with that, because that's never gonna be good enough, especially if it becomes a road hazard. You know, you wanna put your safety and the safety of others first before anything else. Make sure it's nice and secure, and that will really go a long way for you and for others potentially. So do it right. That way you won't have to go back and keep doing it again and again and again. If you do it right the first time, you'll be safe and you'll be solid. All right, so we are pretty much complete on the front splitter at this point. The only other things that I need to do are make my side winglets and paint the trim. And I'm gonna be doing the paint work today. I'm actually gonna mask it off as soon as I finish recording this video and just throw that paint on there. And I don't think I need to show you guys that, because you know what that's pretty much gonna entail. The winglets are just gonna be, I cut that black piece of ABS that I showed you earlier, that little scrap piece that I just dropped. This piece right here, I cut it into two. And so this is approximately the size that I need for the sides. I'm just gonna cut it down into a shape that I like. It's gonna be something similar to this that's on the diffuser already, but it's just gonna be mounted right there. So it's gonna be that 3/4 inch separated from the bumper. It's gonna look absolutely sick. I did a little mock-up with some white pieces right here, like this, and just kind of stuck. This isn't even close to the actual shape it's gonna be, but kind of put some double side tape and just kind of mocked it up like that. So it's gonna be something like that, but it's gonna look way better than that from the front. I mean, look at that. That's gonna look absolutely massive, dude. So anyway, this was a long video. This was a long process. Like I had said before, it could have potentially taken a week, and it sure did. It took me 5 days from conception to finish on this thing, but it was well worth it. I'm so glad that I fought the good fight and got it on there. I'm so happy with this thing at this point, and it's gonna look even better with the gold trim and the winglets and everything. It's gonna really pull it all together. So I wanna thank you guys, all of you guys who have stuck through this long video and watched this thing. Thank you all of you who are subscribed to me and just checking out my channel, checking out my car. I appreciate it very, very much as always. I do apologize about the lack of videos for the last week. Not only have I been having the camera issues, but
Like I said, this task took me quite a while to make the splitter, so you know, I got it up as quickly as I could. So don't worry, more videos will be coming. We're getting right into the flare project next. I'm super excited about that. Hope you guys are too. Thank you again for watching. I will see you guys on the next one.